Now, God deals with nations, and you say, what have we to do with it? A lot more to do than you might suppose. In Ezekiel chapter 22 and verse 30, the Lord said, Israel's gone into captivity. I seemed helpless. For God said, I sought for a man to stand in the gap, and there was none. And since God didn't have anybody to come with raging and denunciation of sin and warning, calling people back to God and to pray all night and day and call the people to fasting and prayer and repentance, since God didn't have a man to stand in the gap, then captivity came to the country and to the land. You remember the story, don't you, in Genesis 18? God came to see Abraham, and Abraham said, now, Lord, let me kill a calf, and we'll have some veal steaks, and you wait. And Sarah made some little cakes of unleavened bread also. And then God said, and when he went away, he said, I can't go without telling Abraham what I'm going to do. He said, the angels have brought such reports of Sodom and Gomorrah, I'm going to have to destroy. And I'll tell Abraham. And Abraham said, but wait, Lord, there's Lot down there now. What about Lot? You wouldn't destroy the righteous with the good. And he said, no. Well, he said, now, Lord, wait. Maybe if he's got down there, if he's got 50 people saved, if there's 50 righteous, will you spare the city? It's wonderful that that Abraham knew that God would sometimes let one man stand for many a righteous man. You know, he said, yes, I would. But wait, he said, now, Lord, Lot's very busy. He's making so much money. Maybe there would be 45. Would you spare it for 45 righteous? Yes, I would. He said, would you spare it for 40? He said, yes, I would. He said, Lord, don't be angry. Would you spare it for 30? He said, yes, I would. He said, would you spare it if there only 20? And yes, he said, I would. Well, now, let's see. You know, Lot's so busy, and he's a little worried. He's not a very good, warm Christian. Maybe he didn't win anybody but his own family. Let's see, there's Lot and his wife, and the three married daughters and the husband, and these two single daughters. If there's 10, if he's got 10 righteous people, would you spare the city? He said, yes, I would. But there were not 10. Not even Lot's own wife, and not the family. And so destruction must come. But wait a minute. If Lot had gotten 10 righteous people, his own family, and his own servants, now God would have given the whole town a chance, and four cities there, Sodom, Gomorrah, Admah, and Zeboah that were destroyed, could have been spared if there had been 10 Christian people with the power of God to pray and intercede. And so, like leaven in the meal is a picture of evil spreading through, there is a sense in which sometimes one man has enough influence with God to stave off judgment on a city. And so now I'm talking to you because we ought to have in America raised up a generation of godly people with old-fashioned family altar in the home and godly and great preaching in the pulpit and devoted living from house to house and winning souls. Maybe God will just spare America from the doom that comes to wicked countries for their sins. Thank you.